what it should be doing for the next 10 years. Now we've got the infrastructure essentially there. Think, for instance, if you, I was at St. Helens Scrutiny Committee last night, you know, they are not talking about putting out new bins or anything like that, but they know they've got to increase the uptake and the participation in their food waste and their recycling service, and they're looking at how to do that. So they're moving into the kind of territory which is to make the most of the existing systems. So most councils have got decent enough systems, but are you sweating those assets to the maximum, and what are you doing about waste prevention and reuse through the third sector, etc.? We only touch the surface of that.
I'm just going to say one thing to you in Sefton is you're only allowed one residual waste bin. You've got to like really, really prove a point to get an extra one, but you can have an extra brown one.
Yeah,
which really helps.
Yeah. You've got to pay for the residual bin, you get to be safe.
Yeah.
I think that's happy there now, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Any further questions or comments? Are we okay? So can we agree that report? So we go on to item 12, which is the Code of Corporate Governance and Annual Governance Statements on page 121. And Paul, are you going to take us through that report?
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
This report is to inform members of the findings of the annual governance assessment and the Improvement Action Plan for 2018-19, and also a review of the progress to date of the 17-18 Improvement Action Plan. The authority does have a Code of Corporate Governance in place, and it's based on the framework recommended by Simple Solids. A primary insurance group is responsible for the continuing assessment and review of the Code of Corporate Governance, and undertakes periodic reviews and to ensure progress is being made against the Improved Action Plan. As part of the annual assessments, the Family Assurance Group reviewed the work undertaken to deliver last year's Improvement Action Plan, and pleased to know that the majority of actions have been completed, with a few still ongoing, and they have been moved forward onto the 2018-19 Improvement Action Plan. The final progress report of the 17-18 Improvement Action Plan is attached to Appendix 2, page 136. This year's annual assessment noted the work undertaken during 2017-18 to strengthen the authority's internal controls, but also identified some new areas of improvement. The key focus for 2018-19 identified during this assessment are detailed on page 124, paragraph 2.5 of the report. A copy of the Improvement Action Plan for 2018 is attached as Appendix 3 on page 139. And a full copy of the annual assessment is attached to Appendix 4 on page 141. As part of the annual assessment, the Primary Assurance Group requires statements of assurance from key officers and organisations to confirm that the authority is actually maintaining robust internal controls. This is obviously because the authority needs this to prepare the statements of accounts. Statements of assurance have been received from the authority's chief executive regarding the control environment, St. Helens MVC as a key provider of services, and Mersey Waste Holdings Limited as an organisation included on the authority's group accounts. Copies of these statements are attached to Appendix 6, 7 and 8 for members' information. Regulation 6 of the Account and Audit Regulations require the authority to prepare and approve an annual governance statement for inclusion on the statements of accounts. This statement is drafted by the Primary Assurance Group, and it reports that there's no significant governance issues that have been identified. Members are therefore asked to approve the annual governance statement attached to Appendix 1, page 129, and agree that it be signed by the authority's representatives as indicated. Members are also asked to note the findings of the annual assessment and approve the Code of Corporate Governance and Improvement Action Plan for 2018-19.
Any questions or observations on that, colleagues? Okay, well, thanks for that, Paula. So there's a set of recommendations on page 121. Can they be agreed?
Okay.
Agreed. Okay, colleagues, so I have no items of other business, so can I just personally thank everybody for all the support. us next year. Hopefully see you again at the next meeting. Thank you very much.
Could I just add my comments to the chair and thank the chair for, you know, the year. His failure that he's conducted the committee of the authority meetings, so well done.
Thank you.
Well,
thank you.
Well,
thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah.